Morning, students. Welcome back to your social science tutorial class. I, Saimalini Sarkar, as you all know, will be taking your social science tutorial class. I hope, students, you all are doing well. Okay, let's start with a new chapter today. Shall we all see? What is the chapter we are going to read today? Occupation. Yes, we are going to start with the chapter occupation. Now, what does the word occupation means? The word occupation means job or profession. See, profession means some people are doctor, some are painter, some are photographer, some are singer, some are traffic police, some are farmer, chef, teacher, plumber, carpenter, barber, tailors. The people, those who are working in their own profession, they possess an occupation. Occupation helps to earn money for livelihood. So students, shall we see what is stored there in the chapter for us? All human beings need three basic things to live: food, shelter and clothing. Now, this food, shelter and clothing, these are the most important things that all the people live in or need in this world to live. They need food to suffice, they need food to live, they need food to live, they need food to survive. They need shelter, house to live. They need clothes to wear to protect them from heat, to protect them from chilled winter. So, the basic things that all human beings need are food, shelter and clothing. In order to fulfill these needs, we have to earn money through some work. Now, from where we will get food, shelter and clothes? We have to earn money for that. To buy crops, to buy pulses, to buy milk, we need money. And how we will get that money? Through occupation, we have to do some job, then only we will get salary and we can earn money. For building house or for making houses, we need money. For buying clothes, we need money. So, to fulfill these needs, we have to earn money. And to earn money, we have to do some work. Any work that helps a person to earn money is called an occupation. Any such work that helps the person to earn money is known as occupation. Suppose teacher, he is working, he is earning money and the occupation of that person is called teaching or the teacher. The person is a teacher. He is there in a teaching profession, right? It is said that work is worship, which means that work should be done with honesty. There are no such work called small or big. We should do whatever work we are doing, we should do with full honesty. As because work is a worship for us. So we should try to give respect to the work we are doing. People follow different occupations according to their ability and needs. All kinds of work are equally important. All the occupations, all the professions are equally important to us. We cannot say that I don't need a plumber. I don't need a cobbler. I don't need a barber. All these professions are very much important for our daily life. Today I today I don't need, but tomorrow, who can say that tomorrow we don't need a plumber? People work at tea stalls, sell flowers, groceries and vegetables, work at construction sites, wash and iron clothes, repair cars and scooters, etc. In addition, there are electricians, teachers, plumbers, doctors, carpenters, tellers, policemen, soldiers, farmers, miners, astronauts, scientists, musicians, sportspersons, and people who work in offices. See, so many professions are there. Everyone is dependent on each other for support. All these professions are dependent on each other for support. Doctor cannot say, I don't need a tailor. Then who will stitch his clothes? Tailor cannot say, I don't need a barber. Who is going to cut his hair? So all the professions are dependent on each other for support. Types of occupation. First, farming or agriculture. We are going to know about the farmers, the Indian farmers. It is the main occupation of the people living in villages. Farmers grow crops, vegetables, fruits, tea, coffee, spices, cotton, pulses, and oilseeds. So all the food crops that we are going to get, who is going to supply us those? The farmers. If farmers were not there, we are not going to get any food grains. Sufficient water, suitable climate, and fertile soil are required for growing crops. Water for farming is supplied from rivers, tanks, wells, canals, and other sources. Most of the farmers depend on the monsoons for water. The Green Revolution helped farmers to increase their crop production. Green Revolution means when they used to get huge quantity of or huge quality of good quality of seeds, farming machines. So that revolution, that incident is known as Green Revolution. There are different types of farming. Terrace farming is done on hills. Terrace farming, they cut the side of the hills like terrace, like stairs. And those farming is known as terrace farming. It looks like stairs so that water doesn't get stagnant over there. Farmers also grow a number of other products which provide employment to a large number of people. These people work in factories and make products which we use in our daily lives. For instance, crops such as jute and cotton are used for making clothes and bags. Now, farmers are producing jute and cotton. Now, who is producing the finished material, the jute bag, cotton bag? Who is producing all those? The people, those who are working in factories, they are bringing the raw material from the farmers and they are producing the finished materials to us, right? The entire process of production requires plenty of labors from the raw stage to the finished product. Thus, these industry provides employment to a large number of people. A few other crops that are used for making products of daily use are sugarcane for making sugar. Sugarcane are cultivated or harvested by farmers. After that, they are brought to the industries or the factories, and there they are. From sugarcane, sugar is produced. Coffee beans to make coffee, same way. Farmers are harvesting coffee beans and it is coming to the factories and it is getting the finished product like coffee. Oil seeds to make various types of cooking oil. Livestock farming. Cattle farming. Goats, cows, buffaloes and bullocks are reared for milk and plowing. Poultry farming. Hens, ducks and geese are reared for their meat and eggs. Sheep and yaks are reared in the mountain regions mainly for their wool. Fish farming, it is mostly carried out in the coastal regions of India. Fishes are reared in freshwater ponds. So what are the three kinds of farming? They are cattle farming, poultry farming and the fish farming. In cattle farming, goats, cows, buffaloes and bullocks are reared for milk and ploughing, used in cultivated fields by the farmers to harvest the land or to plough the land. Poultry farming, hens, ducks and geese are reared for their meat and eggs. Sheep and yaks are reared in the mountain regions mainly for their wool. And fish farming, it is mostly carried out in the coastal regions of India. Fishes are reared in freshwater ponds. Forestry. Forests provide shelter to animals, birds and insects. They also provide timber for building houses, ships and furniture. Timber means the wood that we get from the trees, that is timber. Trees like teak, sal and sandalwood are found in the forests. The wood from the forest is used to make cardboards, matchsticks, brushes, shelves and paper. Many people work in the factories where these products are made. People also collect things like gum, honey, herbs, lac and rubber from forests. So, see, forest is so important for us. We are getting timber from trees and from timber we are building houses, sheep and furnitures. We are getting teak, sal and sandalwood, which are very helpful for us or useful for us to make furnitures. We are making cardboard, matchstick, shelves, paper from trees. Not only that, we are collecting gum, honey, herbs, lac and rubber also. And this all we get from forests. Mining. The process of obtaining coal and other minerals from the earth, such as iron, copper, mica, coal, manganese, etc., is called mining. These minerals are extracted and sent to factories. They are then converted into stainless steel, iron, and aluminium. Mining is the main occupation of people who live near these areas. These metals are used for making railway engines, cars, machines, bicycles, aeroplanes, buses, ships, sewing machines, etc. Gold, silver and diamonds are used for making jewelry. Many people work in mines, steel plants and other factories which produce a wide variety of products. So what is mining? Mining is the process of obtaining coal and other minerals from the earth, such as it can be iron, copper, mica, coal, manganese, etc. This process is known as mining. Transport industry. The transport industry also employs a number of people. Nowadays, various means of transport are used for carrying goods and people from one place to other. Natural products or raw material are transported to the factories and then the finished product is taken to the markets. Every industry is dependent on each other for various services. Now, who is going to bring the raw materials from field to the factories? They need a transport system. And also the finished product, who is going to bring to the markets? It is also need of a transport system. It also requires a transport system. So every industry we can say is dependent on each other for various services. People who helps us. Our country and its borders are protected by the Indian Army. The water surrounding our country is protected by the Indian Navy and the skies are protected by the Indian Air Force. So the land is protected by the Indian Army, water is protected by the Indian Navy and air is protected by the Indian Air Force. So they are helping us. There are some people who are very important for us in our daily lives because of the work they do. For example, doctors, teachers, policemen and postmen. So these are the example, few example of people, those who are working for us. Doctors. Doctors play a very important role in our lives. When we are unwell or injured, we visit a doctor for treatment. The best example we can give is now the recent situation during this pandemic. Who is the most important person that we need now is the doctors. They are just like God to us. Without them, we couldn't survive. The doctor gives medicines, treats our wounds and tell us what to eat when we are ill. If we have a serious health problem, the doctor may advise us to get admitted so that a thorough checkup can be done. Vaccinations are given by doctors which protect us from diseases like polio and cholera. Teachers. Teachers play an important role in shaping our lives. We all know that. They teach us how to read and write. They also encourage us to learn and participate in dance, music, sports, theater, painting and many other activities. Not only they help us to read and write, but they also encourage us to participate in dance, music, sports, theater, painting and many other activities. They train us to be confident, kind, respectful and honest, and teach us good habits, values and manners. We must love and respect our teachers. Policemen. The duty of the police is to maintain law and order. They protect our lives and property. The head of the police is a city, is called the police commissioner. So what is the duty of the policeman? The duty of the police is to maintain law and order. They protect our lives and property. The head of the city police is called the police commissioner. Every city has police headquarters, police stations and police mobile vans. Now what are police mobile vans? Which patrol different areas in cities. It's just move around to see that everything is there in a right position or everything is there in a proper situation. If there is a problem, we can call the police for help by dialing 100. The traffic policemen manage the traffic. Traffic rules should be followed by everyone. Postmen. The postal services in India started on April 1, 1774, and are more than 240 years old. The letters we post are collected by the postman and taken to the post office. The letters are then sorted according to the addresses of different cities and are sent to their destination by air or railways. We can also send parcels and money orders by post. The letters which are received at the post office are taken by the postman and delivered to their respective addresses. Many courier services have started in the cities. Now I know. Let's have a quick recap on the chapter that we have learned now. Any work that enables a person to learn to earn money is called an occupation. Any work that enables a person to earn money is called an occupation. People follow different occupations according to their ability and needs. The main occupations are farming, animal rearing, mining, transport and other services. We are all dependent on each other for various services. We need a number of people to help us in our daily lives. Doctors, teachers, postmen and policemen help us with their services. Let's go through the difficult words that we have came across while reading the chapter. First, Green Revolution. the use of high-yielding seeds, HYS, fertilizers and machines that led to an increase in the production of crops in India. Labor, work, especially physical work or employment. Employment, work. Extract, remove or take out, especially by effort or force. Natural products, things which we get from nature such as wood, water, minerals, etc. Vaccination, a substance injected into the body which protects us from diseases. Patrol, to go around an area at regular intervals to check that it is safe. Courier, a person or a company that transports goods or documents. So students, we have reached to the end of the chapter. I hope we have understood that how all the professions are important to us, are helping us day and night. And after reading the chapter, I think we all should start giving more respect to all the people, those who are working for us. Please read the chapter well, be safe and stay healthy. Bye bye students.